Hello, camera.
I would say pop, rock, soul.
All right.
I don't know. I don't like talking about my own music. It's hard. It's hard to kind of. Yeah, I'd say pop, rock, soul, because it's a bit of. It's poppy, but it's slightly rock and it's slightly soulful. So yeah. All those things together. Quite a few, actually. Songwriters like Van Morrison and obviously like Bob Dylan and David Bowie, all the, like kind of classic sort of, you know, songwriting really. But voices, in terms of voices, people with a soulful voice, like whether it's Van Morrison or Otis Redding or Stevie Wonder, Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson was the first person I ever really loved when I was a kid, and I suppose I like his attack, the way he attacks vocals. I suppose I like that about soul music. They attack the vocal. It's not, they're not too precious about the technique. They're just like singing. I like music like that. There's a few, but I suppose in terms of like the musicality and each track being different and amazing, Songs in the Key of Life has always been one of my favourite all-time albums. There's quite a few that make me shiver. Most things by Otis Redding, actually. Try a Little Tenderness always gives me goosebumps. But I like Al Green as well. Al Green's really good at that. The high-end stuff, when he goes really soulful at the high-end. But songs like How Do You Mend a Broken Heart, that always gives me goosebumps. Or Eva Cassidy, which I'm not massively into her music, but her voice is so good. When she sings that note on the golden thread, I get goosebumps every time. Yeah, she's definitely got one of those voices that does that. I'd say Jimi Hendrix, but I don't think I'd be able to jam with it. Maybe Kurt Cobain, is probably dark though, isn't he? I don't know. I think, Jimi Hendrix would be pretty fun. Uh-huh. Yeah.
All right, I thank you so much for your time and your
kindness.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Adios.